Hello everyone, my name is Gaurav Sharma. I am a product manager for Amazon Keyspaces for Apache Cassandra. In this video, I'm going to show how you can start using Amazon Keyspaces for your Cassandra workloads. I'll show how to create a keyspace.
Create a table and add some data to it. This is our agenda for today. I'll provide a brief introduction of what Amazon Keyspaces is. I'll go through the steps for creating keyspace and table, inserting and updating that data using the AWS console. I will walk you through how to create credentials in order to use the SQL Shell command line interface. Then we will use the SQL Shell to perform the same steps that we did using the AWS console. And finally, I will share with you some information on how to get started with Keyspaces and further resources. Amazon Keyspaces for Apache Cassandra is a scalable, highly available, and managed Apache Cassandra compatible database service. With Keyspaces, you can run your Cassandra workloads on AWS using the same Cassandra application code and developer tools that you're using today. You don't have to provision, patch, or manage any servers, or install or operate software. In addition, Keyspaces is fully serverless, so you only pay for the resources that you use. The service can automatically scale up and down table capacity in response to application traffic. Keyspaces also makes the job of managing Cassandra clusters easier. With Keyspaces, there are no tombstones, no compaction strategies to manage, no read repairs, or garbage collection to manage. You also get single-digit millisecond performance at any scale, and enterprise features such as encryption and backup are standard. Keyspaces offers 99.99% availability SLA within an AWS region, and with multi-region replication, where you can have the same tables across different AWS regions, we offer a 99.999% SLA.
I'm creating a table called customer in the Keyspace bank. I'm defining my schema as follows. Schema is essentially the columns that I want to define for my table. I'm using zip, ID, name, email, age as the information that I want to store for a particular customer in this table. I've also selected a partition key to be the zip code. Data in Amazon Keyspaces in Apache Cassandra is grouped and stored by partition keys. Hence, all the rows for the same partition key will be in the same logical partition. I've also selected ID to be my clustering column, and I've selected the order as ascending. Clustering columns give you a way of further sorting the data within a particular partition. I'm going to use default table settings to create this table. And again, at the bottom, you can see the query preview if you wanted to use this query to create the table using the SQL Shell. Now that the table has been created, we can use the built-in SQL editor in Amazon Keyspaces to manipulate the data in the table. If you click on Query Table, you'll see the SQL editor, run the command. The output at the bottom shows that the table is empty as expected. I'm going to insert some data into this table. Some information about a particular customer. Run the command. We see that the command executed correctly. And you can see that our row was inserted into the table. Next, I will update some data in the row that we just inserted. I'm going to change the age of our customer from 21 to 22. Run the command. And we can see that the age did indeed get updated to 22. Next, I'll show the steps required to create the security credentials needed to access Amazon Keyspaces through the SQL Shell CLI interface. I'm here in the IAM dashboard in the AWS console. The first step is to go under the user section. And if you don't already have a user, you can add a user, provide a name. We recommend attaching an access policy directly In this case, since you'll be accessing Amazon Keyspaces, you can search for Keyspaces and attach the policy for Amazon Keyspaces full access. The user has been created. Next step, you click on the user, go to the security credentials, and scroll down until you reach the section called Credentials for Amazon Keyspaces. You click on Generate Credentials. These are the security credentials that you will use to connect to Amazon Keyspaces through SQL Shell. I'm here in a terminal window, and I will be connecting to Amazon Keyspaces using SQL Shell. This is my command line, and the Amazon Keyspaces endpoint that I'm connecting to is this one right here. This is a public endpoint. Amazon Keyspaces is available in multiple regions. I'm connecting to US East one in particular. I'm connected to Amazon Keyspaces. What I'll do is select and see what the data is in my customer table in the bank Keyspace that I created earlier using the AWS console. As you can see, we have one row, John, age 22. Next, I am going to insert some more data from the SQL shell and perform some updates. But in order to do so, I need to set the consistency level to local quorum. I will now insert a new record into our table. And as you can see, the data has been inserted. Now I'll update the record that we just inserted and change the age to 22. I'll also demonstrate how you can create a table from the SQL shell. I will create a duplicate of our customer table, and I'll call it customer underscore 2. That's it, our table has been created. Getting started with Amazon Keyspaces is easy. We have a free trial offer where you can try Amazon Keyspaces for free for 3 months. We also have tutorials and documents available which can quickly help you get started. To learn more, please see some of the resources below.